Hello guys and welcome to The Bro Thing. This is your coach Arunav and today I'm launching one of my first episodes of my 12 episode series on online dating. After watching these episodes, you're going to be an expert in online dating. You're going to have an edge over the other profiles. So stay tuned because we have a lot of valuable information coming right your way. And apart from that, watch this video till the very end because we're going to give you a lot of free gifts. Alright guys, so welcome to the first episode of the online dating series, and firstly I would like to talk about the components of a good profile. Now I'm not talking about the components of any profile, I'm talking about the components of a good online dating profile, and I'm talking about the top 1% profiles out there. Now if you have not joined our Facebook group, I highly recommend you join that because over there you can just post your profiles and I'll give you a feedback. Apart from that guys, the components of a top online dating profile is very simple. Alright, the first component is the bio. Second component is the pictures, and the third component is the prompts, the verification badge, and small things like that. Now, every dating application is a bit different. However, the base of all dating applications remains the same. What I mean by that is the bio is going to be in the similar concept. The pictures are going to have a similar story, similar concept, and we're going to talk more about it. So let's talk about the bio first. Now, I know a lot of people, you know, when they are making their online dating profiles, they have this bio like 6'3", writer, traveler, looking for something, looking for a friend. Now guys, all of these bios make you look low value. And what I mean by that is the girl knows why you are on the dating application. So do not try to cover it up. Do not try to hide that thing, because the girl is also there to, you know, find someone whom she can go out on a date with, meet with, and hopefully have something, you know, long term or maybe something casual. It depends on the girl. But if you have a bio like 6'3", writer, guy who's a traveler, what happens is you try to project all of that just through the words and it won't work out. But instead of using your bio to project that, you should use your pictures. And what I mean by that is use pictures which show some attributes about you. All right, do not use, you know, any picture where you're looking good, right? I see this with a lot of people just taking any picture out of the social media and using it. What I want to say is you have 5 pictures, all right? You have 5 to 7 pictures depending on the different dating applications. But what I personally use is I use 5 pictures, and each picture has to convey a story. Now the first picture holds 70% of the value, guys. Remember that. So if you have a first picture where the girl can't see your face, where, you know, it's just scenery or something like that, what will happen is the girl will not even scroll down to your profile. However, she'll just skip it. She'll be like, okay, maybe I don't know. And the first picture is going to hold 70% of the value. So the first picture always should be a very clear headshot where the girl can see your eyes, because women, they think that they can notice everything by the guy's eyes. I'm not sure if it's real or not, but they want to see your eyes. All right. So don't have squinted eyes. Don't take pictures in a very heated atmosphere where the sun is directly shining in your eyes, because you'll have squinted eyes or else. So make sure the first picture, you pay a lot of attention to the first picture, a clear headshot with a decent fashion sense. Now, apart from that, guys, pictures should always convey some attributes. And what I mean by that is a picture should convey a million words. It should not be just be a picture like, okay, you just went out, you just clicked a picture on the sofa. You just went out, you clicked a picture somewhere else. So every profile should have a profile story. And we're going to talk about the profile story in the next episode, but I'm just going to give you an overview. Now, the profile story has to be based on your lifestyle. You can't just make a profile story, you know, by amplifying your lifestyle a lot, because once the girl meets you, she's going to figure out that, okay, you're not the same guy who's, you know, whose profile it is. So make sure your profile story is always according to your lifestyle. And what I mean by that is if I'm a student, an 18-year-old student, my profile story is going to be very different from a guy who's an entrepreneur who's 26. If I'm an IT guy, my profile story is going to be very different than a guy who's probably a coach, which is my profile right now. Now, what I mean is the profile story has to be congruent, has to be in harmony with your lifestyle. And the pictures should be in harmony with your profile story. And we're going to talk about it in the next session. However, just understand one basic principle. You should be 2/3 or 1/3 of the whole picture, the frame. You should be 2/3 or 1/3 of the whole picture, because in an online dating application, the girl wants to see who she's talking to. She doesn't want to talk to anyone. She doesn't want to talk if your pictures is blurry, if your picture are low quality. So make sure you use a DSLR. And if you don't have a DSLR, that's not a problem. All you need to do is join the Facebook group. You'll definitely find some people over there who you can help and who can help you in turn. Now, apart from that, guys, the next key component is their small components like prompts, like questions on Bumble. And on Tinder, I think it's the verification badge. Even on Bumble, you have the verification badge. And this is one of the really important things to do, because understand, a lot of girls are meeting, texting people who have fake profiles. Now, some girls, the higher quality women, do not even talk to men if they don't have a verification badge, because they don't want to get catfished. So verification badge is really important. And do not miss out on this step. I see a lot of people missing out on the verification badge because they think, okay, you know, maybe it's not that important. I'm still getting matches. But definitely, guys, it improves the quality of your matches as well as the number of matches that you want to get over the period of time. Now, apart from that, guys, I also want to share with you a strategy. And after the strategy, I'm going to break down my own profile. Now, guys, this strategy is for this whole series. And I want you to follow this strategy. And in this strategy, guys, it's pretty simple. It's pretty basic. All you need to do is you need to create two dating profiles. One on Tinder, one on Bumble. And test one online dating application every month. So these two profiles is not going to take you more than 10 minutes or 15 minutes, because you need to do the shoot once, and we're also going to cover that up in the next episodes. However, you only need to do the shoot once, and then you can create two profiles within 5 to 10 minutes. All right. Now, Tinder and Bumble are the applications which are working globally, which are working everywhere mostly. Now, apart from that, you might have some indigenous dating applications such as OKC for Chennai. Right, some applications which might be working good in your city, but which might not work good globally or universally. And if you are in a small town, if you are in a town which does not have a lot of dating applications, does not have a lot of women on dating applications, then you need to test the third app. For people who are in Delhi, Mumbai, Bangalore, or different cities, different country, I think that's still all right, because you'll find a lot of women on Tinder and Bumble. But if you are from a different town, if you're from a smaller town, then guys, make sure you test a third application every month. Now, once you have done your shoot, once you have written your bio, it's time to create two dating profiles, one on Tinder, one on Bumble, and test one application every month. Now, apart from that, guys, I also want to break down my own profile so you get a better idea on how a profile should look like. All right, guys, now without further ado, let's get down to the profile. Now, guys, as you can see with this profile, I created this profile last night, and I have already gotten like 10 matches. But the thing you have to understand about this profile is it's the top 1% profile. And why is it a top 1% profile? That we want to break down right now. So, as you can see, the first picture is a very clear headshot. Now, guys, it's a selfie. However, I don't recommend people to use a selfie, because I know if people listening to this, click just selfies like this, normal selfies, it's never going to work out. Now, in this selfie, I've clicked it like this, a side shot, but it doesn't look like a selfie. And apart from that, I have good fashion sense. The lighting is just perfect. It's sunset. And you'll get the best pictures on sunset or sunrise. And apart from that, as you can see, I'm not covering up my eyes, right? My eyes are not squinted in any way. And it's a very decent picture. Now, when the girl sees this, she will definitely move on to the second picture. And the objective of the first picture is not much. It's just that the girl should get an idea about who you are as a person, who she's talking to. And let's go down to the second picture. Now, before the second picture, I also want to break down my bio. Ex-restaurateur, now helping people perfect their character and become untroubled spirits. Making a living out of my conversations, so you bet I'm good at it. Not here to waste my time on half-hearted interactions, looking for someone to hang out with. Now guys, with this bio, I read a lot of bios before creating this one online. I went all over, some forms, some letters, articles, whatever. I read a lot. But everywhere I saw was, 6'3 traveler or some jokes. And what happens is you need to put your best foot forward in your bio. All right, you need to be a bit cocky, you need to be a bit funny and a bit humorous as well. And with this bio, it's a very personalized bio. You can't use the same bio because, I worked in the restaurant industry. I was a hotelier. However, for you, this might not make any sense. So that's what we do. If you get a shoot done by us, we give you a very personalized bio. Now, apart from that, guys, as you can go on to the second picture, as you can see, it's a picture of me working on a laptop. Now, this shows my work, who I am as a person. It's a day from my life. And apart from that, the idea behind the second picture is to raise the girl's curiosity. Now, with this picture, I raise the girl's curiosity. Okay, this guy is he's a well-dressed man. Let's check out more about him. Now, swipe right if you don't complain much. A very basic qualifier. I'm not over-investing. I'm like, only if you don't complain much. That's about it. And the third picture is a picture of me in an Indian ethnic clothing. It was clipped in a wedding. And it came out to be really good. Now, again, guys, this is all professional photography, right? However, I can't just have all professional photography in my profile, because if I do that, then the girl will feel that, okay, I took one day out of my day to get all pictures professionally shot. And for that reason, in my fourth picture, I have a picture of TEDx, right, where I'm giving a TEDx talk. Now, I know a lot of people cannot get this picture. However, guys, this is, you know, profile out of my lifestyle. This is a profile which is congruent to my lifestyle. And you have to make a profile which is congruent to your lifestyle, whatever you do, all right? Now, the last picture, again, good fashion sense, working on my laptop, and that's about it, right? What you can see is the lighting is perfect, the framing is nice, and 2/3 or minimum 1/3 of the frame. And apart from that, this profile already got me like 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 matches in like a single day, not even a single day, I think 8, 9 hours. So I think it's a amazing profile. And apart from that, guys, this is how you should create your profile. Make sure that the pictures you select, the pictures you, the story you want to convey through the profile is conveyed through the pictures, all right? Now, my profile tells a story about me. 99% of the profiles out there do not tell a story about a person. What 99% of the profiles out there are like is, you know, a picture on a sofa, a picture wearing a shirt, a picture wearing a suit, right? But the pictures do not tell attributes, do not tell more about you to the other person. So make sure that the picture conveys a million words. All right, guys, I hope in this video you learn how to create and plan your profile, how to create that top 1% profile that gives you an edge over the other profiles. Now, apart from that, if you need our help to create the top 1% profile, I strongly suggest go in the comment section below, click the pinned comment, sign up for the email newsletter, because we have something really special for you. We have written down an online dating manifesto, which will teach you everything you need to know on how to get good with online dating. And apart from that, there are several different guides, there are different email chains that we have written, which will dive deep into different segments, different paths of online dating. This is your coach Arunav, and I'll see you in the next episode.